ॐ वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदं वागर्थाविव सम्पृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वतीपरमेश्वरौ येनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम् ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। Before we start, do you have any doubts in this sutras, what we saw? We have seen about how many sutras? 100 and 27, 132 sutras. We have seen 132 sutras so far. If you have any doubts in these sutras, any sutra, you can ask. Any doubts? Amma ji, Parvati ji, Krishna ji, Sushila ji. Yes?
No ji, no ji.
No sir.
No ji, just have to.
We have to revise.
Then I can ask them question, right?
No.
Krishna ji.
Yes.
Will I ask?
Yeah, well, I can try.
Okay. No, I will not. I will ask whatever comes. Okay. Sometimes I'll give the sutra. You have to explain what the sutra is. Okay. What is this sutra? Adirantena Saheta.
It is a Pratyahara Nirmana Sutra.
Pratyahara Nirmana Sutra. Okay. Can you explain that? Audio. Okay,
so if take the Maheshwara Sutrani. So Adi Varnaha, then the Antima It Varnaha Paryantam. Antarbhuta Sarve, it qualifies all the Varnas between the first letter and the last ith letter, excluding the last ith letter.
How do you exclude a last ith letter? No, it's not qualifying, it is a grouping of letters, right?
Yeah, grouping of letters, yes.
Grouping of letters is called Pratyahara. So, Pratyahara Nirmana Sutra. Otherwise, Pratyahara Sutra, Pratyahara Sanya Sutra also you can say. Adirantena Saheta. Okay. So continue. What is it? How do you do the nirmanam?
Yeah, so the, you take the Adi letter, say, and the Antima is the, has to be the Ith letter.
Hmm.
And then you also include all the Madhyama Varnas between the Adi Varna and the Antima Ith Varna. And in between, if there are, in between, if there are Ith letters, that is excluded.
But that is excluded. Not, that is not said here. Adirantina Saheta, that is excluded. Where it is said, that should not be. What do you mean by excluded?
What do you mean
by what sutra you remove that the ith letters?
Tasya lopaha.
By tasya lopaha, yes, that lopaha is adarshan lopaha. Tasya lopaha is a sanya, in fact, you know. Tasya lopaha, lopaha is a sanya. I mean, that sutra is not saying that. Tasya lopaha bhavati. What is lopaha you have to say?
Lopaha is you will say how it is. Okay, the, all the ith letters halantiyam. So halantiyam karanena, it gets lopaha.
Halantiyam is what is halantiyam?
And that's the sanya sutram to define the. I mean, the halantiyam is the sanya sutram that defines the last varna as the ith letter.
Halantiyam is it a Sanya Sutra?
Halantiyam is a Sanya Sutra. Right, it is Sanya, right? No?
Antiyam Al. Okay, you are giving it Sanya to this Al. Antimahal.
Antimahal, Antimahal.
Okay, that, but what is Hal?
What is Hal? What is Hal? Sarve.
Venjanani.
Venjanani.
Sarvani Venjanani.
Sarvani Venjanani.
But Hal itself is a Pratyahara or not?
Yes, it is a Pratyahara.
You are forming a Pratyahara by the Sutra Adhirantina Sagheta. Still, you have not formed the Pratyahara. If you are not from the Pratyahara, you are using the Pratyahara to dismiss the Antyam Hal as it. How is it possible? There is a Anyonya Ashraya. Is there or not? Itara itara Ashraya. I depend on you and you depend on me. So we cannot initiate any activity. Right? Anyway, that's a technical discussion. Just it's okay. It's not, we are not going to discuss that. I'm just saying for that. The Bhashyakara, Mahabhashyakara, it gives a nice interpretation. Anyway, that is not required, I'm just saying. Anyway, it's good, fine. But there is a, all these are extra, okay, all these are not extra, these are to be discussed later, not now. So it is fine, what you understood is fine. But you see that paraspara ashrayatvam.
Yes, yeah. I was thinking.
Yeah, it is paraspara ashraya. Then, Adirantine Sageta, for that you need this Alantyam, you need. But Hal itself is a Pratyahara. Without that, you cannot, you know, really do this. Adirantine Sageta. So, it's got Anyonya Ashrayatvam. Anyway, that these things we don't see. We don't have to see now. But it's all discussed in the other Grantha. Mahabhashyakara discusses. Kashikakara discusses this. Anyway, these are all second level of study. Not everything cannot be done in the beginning itself. Yeah, otherwise, your study will never end. First one round of study, then second round of study, then third round of study. So as long as we live, so long we study and learn. That's it. It's a continuous thing. So no knowledge is complete, really speaking. It is always growing, growing, growing. Okay. Then, see, ith letter, ith prakaranam, it is in first chapter, third section, ith prakaranam, starting from upadeshe ajaranasika ith. The word anunasika is there, that is why I introduced in the beginning what is anunasika letter. Mukha vachana, mukanasika, vachanaha anunasika. Okay, this, let me ask, is anunasika and anuswara, are they same?
No.
They are not same. This is another confusion. People have not, of course, this class. The anunas, anuswara, anunasika, they are not same. Then what are anunasikas?
The panchama of each vargiya or anunasika. The prayat.
Yes. Panchama?
Of each the vargiya or anunasika. And yavala.
That yava, that, yes, anunasika. They are all anunasika. Ushmavarna doesn't have anunasika component. Repa doesn't have anunasika.
And ach letters.
Ach letter has got anunasika. Right? Ach letter has got anunasika. So this anunasika is the place of pronunciation of that particular class consonant, if it's suppose if it's a class consonant. So, or if it is a semi-vowel. Semi-vowel, yeah, has got its the place of pronunciation. In addition to that, nasika, nose, anunasika. Nasika, ya saha vartate, anunasika. So, that's why mukha is there. Mukha referring to the mouth, the uccharana sthanam. Mukha sagita nasika, ya mukha nasika. Mukha sagita nasika, ya vachanaha is shabdaha. Ucharanam annasika bhavati. That is a sanya sutra. So, whereas anuswara is purely nasika. Nasika anuswarasya, right? Nyamangana nanam nasika cha vises cha in Shiksha Sutra. If you see Shiksha Sutra, vises cha. Why cha nasika also? Because main place of pronunciation plus nasika. That is why anunasika. And the rules are different. Anuswara, anuswara se parasvaranaha, that is one rule. Whereas anunasika is yaraha anunasike, anunasikova, right? So the anuswara is a sanya, anunasika is a sanya. Anuswara is not defined, but we know anuswara is that bindu. That makara can become anuswara, monuswaraha, and that not only that padanta makara, even apadanta nakara makara also can become anuswara. By what sutra?
Naschavya prashan.
Naschavya prashan,
no. No. Nascha padantasya jali.
Nascha padantasya jali. Ramaji, remember? Parvatiji. Yes.
To practice.
Ramaji, Asantiji, what about unmute your mic? Mic is unmute.
Ji, can you repeat the question again? So I edited.
Yeah, I will repeat the question, but do you recall the sutras? These sutras, 132
yes,
sutras.
Yes, I'll try.
You please read every day few sutras. At least one sutra a day. Keep reading, even though you have read, so that it will stay in the mind. Because these are required, all these sutras are required for the study. Okay. What question I asked? I asked, yes. Padanta makara becomes anuswara, right?
Yes.
I asked, what is the sutra? I asked, Vasantiji.
Monuswara.
Yes. What else can become anuswara? Yes.
What else?
Apadanta nakara. Apadanta nakara or makara. Apadanta nakara makara also can become anuswara when followed by jal letter. Nascha apadantasya jali. Remember the sutra number? Sutra where it is located.
3-4.
8-3-2-4. It's in the Tripadi section. Tripadi. Let's say the number, the location of the sutras are also important to be wrong. These 132 sutras, I try to make this in a particular order. You can see the sequence. Maybe some more sutras can be inserted. That's always possible. But this sets a sequence. And I thought these sutras are required for getting into Tingantam or Subantam or any even Tadita, any topic, we need all this application. In addition to that, extra a special sutram involved in each topic. These are the basic thing. Okay. So, what is the sutra which gives a padasanya?
Suttiyantam
pilandam padam.
Extended padasanya. The padasanya is extended to further. Important one. You have seen that. Padasanya is extended.
Extended. Oh, to that all those. This Subanna Pratyaya. Subhartaya.
Yeah. Somebody is saying.
Samasa Antaha.
Not some, that Pratipadika is saying.
Oh, Pratipadika, sorry.
That's Pratyaya. Pratyaya. Third, 3/2 and 3, 4, 5, 7.
Yes, yes. What are they called? What's the sutra for it?
What are they called?
The sutram is.
So Suda Nap. No. So, okay.
Suva Adishu Asarvanamastane.
Asarvanamastane.
So, we should know what is Sarvanamastana. What is Sarvanamastana?
Sup.
Sup. Not Sup. Sup is Rote. Vibhakti.
That what is Suda Nasik? Suda.
What is Sarvanamastana? It's a Sanya. That also we covered, I think, here. Is there? Must be. Yes. She Sarvanamastanam.
She.
Right? Sarvanamastanam is she. What is she? Here it is. 142. What is she?
This anxious.
What is she?
Just and
Shas, Sharanji,
two
exactly, things. Yes. Just and Shas, they are replaced by she. Okay, they are not called, I mean, just Sashago, she is, just and Shas are replaced by she. She is called Sarvanamastanam. Therefore, just and Shas are called that 1, 3, and 2, 3. Just and Shas, they are not called Sarvanamastanam because she is Sarvanamastanam. She as an Adesha replaces a Stani just and just for Napumsakalinga. Therefore, that since just is replaced by she is a Sarvanamastanam. Therefore, we call it as a Sarvanamastana Pratyaya. Right? Similarly, Shas also. This is for Napumsakalinga. Then what about other linga? Two lingas. Pullinga and Shrilinga. Which are Sarvanamastana Pratyas?
First five, Suva, Jas, Amav.
What is a Sanya for? What is the Sutra for it? That's a Sanya.
Suda Napum.
The screen itself, it is there. We don't have to
Suda Napum Sakasya.
After 1142, 1143, Suda Napum Sakasya. Sut Anapum Sakasya. Anapum Sakasya is negating Napumsaka, right? Negating Napumsaka and other than Napumsaka. Other than Napumsaka means what? How many lingas are there? Napumsaka not there means it is Strilinga
And Pullinga.
And Pullinga. So it is a type of Pratisheda, Paryudasa Pratisheda we call. See, the pratisheda, the negation is of two types. Paryudasa pratisheda, prasajya pratisheda. Prasajya pratisheda is negation in the form of don't do this, like that would be there. Anratam navaktavyam, it is paryuda, prasajya pratisheda. Paryudasa pratisheda is abrahmanam anaya, the stock example. Brahmanam na anaya. There's a ritual or a ceremony going on. You have to bring a person, and the person should not be a Brahmana. You have to bring a person, there is no choice. but the person should not be Brahmana, that is Pratisheda. What is Pratisheda? What is prohibited is it should not be a Brahmana. Abrahmanam Anaya. Anaya is a must. There is no choice for it. You have to bring, but it should not be a Brahmana. Paryudasa Pratisheda, the name of such Pratisheda is called Paryudasa Pratisheda. That is what here is. Anapumsakasya, when we say, not Napumsaka. It means, if Napumsaka is not there, then what is? It will be without any linga. No, it means Pullinga and Srilinga. Paryudasa Pratisheda. A little technical thing, Paryudasa Pratisheda, we will discuss later when other topics. Anachicha, many places it is used, you will see in Sutrapada itself. Okay. So these three sutras we remember together. Just Sashoho, Shihi, 7120. You can see this is in 7th chapter. Just Sashoho, Shihi, sutra is not complete. Complete means unless you bring it as being the words as Anuruddhi. Napum Sakat, that is there. Napum Sakat comes as Anuruddhi. Napum Sakat, Just Sashoho is Shashti Vrutti. Tasyastane Shi Adesha Bhavati. And she is Sarvanamastanam defined in 1142. What is she? She is called Sarvanamastanam. It is Sanya. And Jasan Shas replaced by she. Therefore, Jasan Shasa, that is called Sarvanamastanam Pratyadi. We say it loosely. And what about for Anapum Sakasya? 1143. Sut Anapum Sakasya. Sut means, again, the Pratyahara is used. Adirantena Sageta, starting from Su. Up to the last letter, with letter, takara, out. So, or just out, sut. Jashva Sandhya has happened in the sutram itself. Therefore, takara has become takara, suda, anapum sakasya, sud plus anapum sakasya, sud anapum sakasya, it has become. Right? Sud anapum sakasya, iti. Okay. And here, Sudanapam Sakasya is Saranamastana. But the question was not that. Okay. Question when we start, Suttingantapadam, Suadishu, Asarvanamastane Padam, right? Na Sarvanamastane, Asarvanamastane. That is also easier. Saranamastana Sanya is important. Then only this sutra will be. Can be understood. Su Adishu. What is Su Adishu? What are these Suadi? Suadi. Suadishu Asarvanamastane. What is Suadishu?
Supratya and all the pratyas are important.
Yeah.
It is not only Supratya. All the pratyas. All the pratyas. Yeah, 4 and 5. Yeah. What pratyas are there in 4th chapter and 5th chapter?
Krit, Dita.
No, Krit is not there. Okay.
Oh, Krit is in 3, sorry. Please start in 4.
This all the 21 pratyas are there.
Three pratyas.
Three pratyas are there.
Tadita
pratyaya. Samasanta pratyas.
Samasanta.
All the pratyas which are added to the Pratipadikam. They are there. All the pratyas which are added to Pratipadikam or which are added to the pratyaya Ni and Aap. Ni is a Srilinga pratyaya. Aap also Srilinga pratyaya. Ni stands for Ni. Aap stands for Tap, Jap, Chap, Dap, Tap. These pratyas. So the pratyas which are added after that, which are found in the 4th chapter, 5th chapter, they are Suadishu. So therefore, this Asarvanamastane Padam not applicable only to Suadi Pratyaya, Supratyas. It is applicable to other pratyas also, which are 4th and 5th. The 3rd chapter are the pratyas. What pratyas are there? 3rd chapter.
Inga Krut.
Siddhanta
Vikarana. Siddhanta pratyas. Think pratyas are there. Think thing pratyas, then krit pratyas. What are they called? We are name is that. So that those pratyas. Very famous name. All thing pratyas.
Sarvadhatukam.
Yes, sarvadhatukam.
Thingshit sarvadhatukam.
Thingshit sarvadhatukam. Arudhatukam. Sheshaha. Right? And there are pratyas in the third chapter which are neither sarvadhatukam nor arudhatukam also. You know? There are some pratyas. In fact, san pratyaya is one pratyaya. Not icha arte san. We'll see that on the later. It is neither a sarvadhatukam nor arudhatukam. It's a pratyaya. Pratyaha kutra bhavati. Where the pratyaya will come?
Dhatu pare.
Pratyaha parascha. The dhatu or pratipadikam, that depends. What is the prakriti that? Prakriti is dhatu or pratipadikam. If it is dhatu, then the pratyas comes after the dhatu are found in the third chapter. If the prakriti is pratipadikam, then it is fourth and fifth chapter. Yeah. From a dhatu, you can derive a kriyapadam. How can you derive kriyapadam from a dhatu? By adding?
Pratyaya.
What pratyaya?
Ting
pratyaya. Ting pratyaya. That is why tingantam padam. Right? Dhatu, from a dhatu, you can derive a padam, kriyapadam, by adding thing pratyaya. Right? From a dhatu, you can derive a pratipadikam also. By adding?
Krit.
Krit pratyas. From a dhatu, you can derive a dhatu also. From a dhatu, we can derive
sanadaya.
Sanadi pratyaya.
Sanadhyan
taha dhatam. Nich pratyaya also. Tenth gana we say.
Yes.
From a dhatu, you can derive a dhatu. From a pratipadikam also, you can derive a dhatu, you know.
Subanta dhatus.
Nama dhatu, subanta dhatus. From a pratipadikam also, you can derive. Atmanaha putram icchati. That is, atmanaha putram icchati, putriyati, form. That is, pratyaya is it. He used the pratyaya, I think the catch pratyaya. Atmanaha, supaha atmanaha catch iti. Sorry, yeah. Catch pratyaya. So from a pratipadikam also you can derive from pratipadikam also you can derive dhatu. These are called namadhatu, subanta dhatu. All these are possible. Fine. That which are not sarvanamasthana pratyaya. Right? And not suha, and not, they are suvadi, but beginning with yakara and nach. This is a very simple question. I myself asked, told. Beginning with yakara, then what the anga will call? Anga will get the padasanya when it is, when the pratyaya is swadi pratyaya.
Oh,
yeah. Swadi pratyaya is asavanamasana pratyaya. If the pratyaya is beginning with yakara, or Ajari
Pratyaya.
Basanya. Echibam, right? Echibam means there you have to see. Yakara plus Aj. Yakara plus Aj. And the Saptami is Echi. Saptami. And therefore, the Anga. Anga gets Sanya. Ba. What is the definition of Anga? That also we saw, I think. We'll see again in detail.
Yeah.
To be discussed in detail. A simple definition of the word anga. Where is that anga sanya?
Pratyaya purvas pratyasya purvam.
Yes. Yeah. Yasmat pratyaya vidhi tadadi pratyaye. Technically, the sutra angam. Yasmat pratyaya vidhi tadadi pratyaye angam 1.4.13. So, this anga sanya, pada sanya, ba sanya, all this you will find in one place. Now we can see Yasmat Pratyaya Vidhi Tadadi Pratyaya Angam. And the Anga will get a Padasanya when it is followed by Supratyaya or Thing Pratyaya, right? That becomes a Padam, not get Sanya. That becomes a Padam. It will not get a Sanya, it becomes a Padam. Then the Padasanya is extended to Nahakye, that and all we will see later, Sithicha. Then Suadishu Asaranamastane, that Asaranamastane that comes to Anurti for Ichibam. If the Asaranamastana Pratyaya follows and the Pratyaya beginning with Yakara or Aj, then the Anga will get the Sanya, Basanya. So, Anga getting the Basanya, Anga getting the Padasanya. So, Anga, which is a Pratipadikam, can get a Padasanya when it is followed by Suadishu Asaranamastana Pratyaya. Anga will become a Padam when you add this to Pratyaya, Thing Pratyaya. That's a small difference. Right? Okay. What is the Pratyaya? What is the Sutram which prohibits the bringing of Savarna to Adesha? There's a Sutra which.
Anudit Savarna is a Chapra.
Anudit
Savarna. Anudit Savarna is here. Aprateha. Aprateha means you have to understand that Pratyaya is Adesha, Anadesha, excepting for Adesha. The Sutra covers all the possible combination, right? But Adesha is same only. So Adesha cannot change. Eko Yanachi, when you say E plus I is E is replaced by Yakara. Whether it is E or E, whatever may be. How many Savarnas possible for E?
18.
What is Savarna? Savarna Sanya.
Tulya Saprayatram Savarnam.
It's then the screen itself. Tulya Saprayatram. Tulya is Samana. Asya is Uchcharana Sthanam. So as from the Asdhatu. As means to throw. The words are thrown from the place of pronunciation. So, Uchcharana Sthanat Asyati Shabdaha Shabdaha Asyate Uchcharana Sthanat. So, Asya and Prayatanam is two types are there.
Bahya Prayatanam and
Antara Prayatanam. That also we discussed. Abhyantara Prayatanam of 5 types, Bahya Prayatanam of 11 types. Right?
Yes.
So, Antara Prayatanam, Bhagya Prayatanam. We discussed, I think, the last class also this. And the Najalav is Ach and Al cannot be a Savarna. So, Najalav. Then the Uchcharana Sthanam of I is, it is what? It is Samvrta or Vivrta?
Vivrta. For Pratyaya Vidhi. In Pratyaya
Yes. Vidhi. In the Pratyaya Vidhi, in the Vyakarana, for all the rules, we take it as Vivrta, but it is Samvrta.
Okay.
So the last sutra of the Ashtadhyayi, 8.468, concludes with this sutra giving back the Samvratam to Akara. So 8.468 we know, and 111 we know. 111 is Riddhi Radhej, right?
Riddhi Radhej.
Riddhi is a Mangala word, Riddhi. That itself becomes a prayer. Then what is that? The Paribhasha Sutram which does the Nirdeshanam of the Sthani.
Alontasya?
No, I'm asking the Sthani is defined by the Sutra.
Shashti Sthane Yoga?
Shashti Sthane Yoga, yes. And the Sthani is also specified by other two supporting Sutras.
Tasmaditi Uttarasya.
Yes. yes tasma riti uttarasya tasmin iti nirdishte purvasya right okay then if the adesha is anekach then what it will replace stani is there then it adesha is anekach will it replace the entire stani or will it replace the last letter of the stani
anekalshit sarvasya
sarvasya stani adesha bhavati so if the adesha is anekal sarvasya the adesha is even though if it is ekal and if it is a shit
sarvasya
if the adesha is anekal and if it is a git then
antima varna sala
antima nicha by default is if its adesha is ekal then
antima
alantasya
so alantasya nicha right if the shashti is not specified only panchami and saptami are there then how to determine the shashti
panchami balavat something
yes 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 panchami baliyan right
so ubhaya... saptami will be the
sani ubhaya nirdishte panchami baliyan isa example remember some example many examples are there in fact I have added more examples from the letter but I thought here added more examples more and more examples to that any one example remember yes in examples right I've given you examples
yes yes
Dasidut is one example, but I don't know whether I taught you that. Dasidut. Okay, if Dasidut is not taught, you can check the other rule, other examples. The example. I give some example. It's difficult to remember, I think. Yidasaha, one example I gave. Then, Ami Sarvanama Naha Sut. Okay. Panchami Baliyan. That we will see. I think the example is difficult for you to remember. Because I've given some examples. It's okay. And you will see some very familiar, simple examples later. Bahor Lopaha Bucha Bahoho. Those are not that one. Idasaha, that's example. Ami Sarvanam Nahasut. Uda Yeet and all, many examples are there. Okay, fine. No problem. Then, there is a Vidhi which is specified when there is a Visheshana, right? What is the root? The Sutram.
Ena Vidhi Tadantasya.
Ena Vidhi Tadantasya. When there is a Visheshana, and ena vidhi is specified ena vidhi tadantasya tat adantat antasya that is
tadantasya tadadav
tadanta vidhi and tadadi vidhi tadantasya when you say that it could be the varna samugha that ending of that shabda or it could be the very shabda it's the letter itself a shabda itself possible ena vidhi tadantasya then similarly tadadi vidhi we saw and there are many vartikams to that some exceptions also we saw right okay then the sandhi rules what is sandhi sanya sandhi
samhitayam
is adhikara sutra definition of or sanya of sandhi
parasannikarsha
samhita yes parasannikarsha samhita Then Sangita is a Sangya. The Sangita, the Sangya is used in many places. Sangitayam is 6172 is there. And 8 to last is Sangitayam. And 6-4 also, the Sangitam, I think it is there. Many places it is used. The Sangita you will see. Sangita. Parasannikarsha. Close proximity is called Sangita. Right? Okay. And the, among the Sandhi, in the context of Vriddhi Sandhi, the Utsarga, Apavada, all those things you have to remember. Engi Pararupam, and Apavada to that is there as Vriddhi Dechi. So all those things, you can refer the chart. Then, okay. I think this is enough. And Urandra Praha. Okay. What is Urandra Praha? Explain Urandra Praha. It is not long, and it is in fact short.
Oh, short. Okay.
Anudit Savanasya only long. Okay.
Okay. Yes.
In all other places, it is only short. And yes.
So Rukara is replaced by the un letter. Yeah. Sada Repa.
Anudatate.
Tadanantaram Agachami.
So Repaha Anudatate. Yadi Rukara Sistane Anadesha Habavati. Yadi Adeshat. Adeshat Anantaram. Repaha. Repaha is Anubadhyate. So Raparaha. Raparaha Paraha Yasmat. Raparaha. Repa comes after which, that is called Raparaha. So if Adesha is A, then it becomes Ar. Then E is, if it is E, Ir and Ur. Iti. Okay. And Stanen Tratamaha, we have seen important sutra. Stana is Stana Sadrishya. The four types of Sadrishya we saw, and that among that, the first one is Stana Sadrishya. Stana is, what is Stana? What is Stana?
Kantha, Kalu, Murda, Oshka.
Yes, all these are Uccharana Stana, right? What are the other Sadrishya?
Guna, Vaya Prayatnam.
Guna Sadrishyam.
Artham.
Artham. The guna is called actually this what we call the guna is called this bhagya prayatna guna sadrishyam, then pramana sadrishyam, artha sadrishyam, right? There's an order. Sthana sadrishyam first, then artha sadrishyam, guna sadrishyam, and pramana. Pramana is the time matra. Pramana sadrishyam. So if you know Sthana Sadrishyam, that's most of the purpose will be solved. That's Sthana Antaratamaha. Okay. Then after that Sandhi, all Achandhi rules we have, you know, remember this. Apavada, Utsarga Apavada, that connection. You have to remember. So we have seen that many times, so I'm not getting into that. Right? Okay. Then in the later 8-2 section, we starting from Khodaha. Choko Kuhu onwards, you have to important. Purvatra Siddham is important. We know very well what Purvatra Siddham is. Purvatra Siddham is the preceding sutra cannot see the result of the succeeding sutra. Or preceding sutra cannot apply on the succeeding sutra. Once succeeding sutras are applied, the results of this, to the results of the succeeding sutra, preceding sutra, I have no access. Cannot see the result. For them, only the previous result only can see. It is with regard to Sapada Saptadaya and also with regard to the sutras, Nitrapadi itself, the preceding sutra. So, 8 to 1, the three chapter, last three chapter, Tripadi. There you have to follow the sequence of the application of these sutras. So Choko Kuku onwards, we saw all these are this unrelated sandhis, consonant sandhis, we can say. Okay. So up to that. And Paribhasha Sutra, in the Sutra Suchi, it is at the end, but we have seen, in the beginning itself we have seen. Okay. So now, we will start Subanta. We will start now Subanta. Subanta already we know, it's not that we don't know, but we are going to see with this Sutra. So, first we will do, okay, Subantam also, two prakaranams are there. In fact, it is six prakaranam. We can divide it into six. How it is six? Ajanta Halanta, that is general division. Halanta prakaranam. Halanta prakaranam. Then Ajanta prakaranam. Within Halanta, we have three linga, pullinga, srilinga, napumsakalinga. Within Ajanta, again, we have pullinga, srilinga, napumsakalinga. Totally six prakaranam. In Siddhanta Kaumudi, you will see discussion by dividing this in this way and elaborate discussion of these sutras and the other commentaries also. The commentary to Siddhanta Kaumudi, each sutra is elaborately discussed with a lot of Purvapakshi questions and answers like that. Examples, counter-examples, in Kashika also, we'll see. So now, we'll start with Halanta Pullinga Prakaran. So whatever sutras we have seen, that we are going to apply. Already, as I said, we have done this. Now, for the sake of the completion, we'll do now this. Okay. So let me start this. So Halanta Prakaranam. Halanta Prakaranam also, what we are going to see is Halanta Prakaranam also, Subanta, sorry, we are going to see Pullinga. Pullinge. Pullinge Vishaye, Halanta Prakarana, Halanta Prakaranam. Now let us take this the word. I'm starting from the Pratipadikam, Lik. Lik we know. Lik is Hakarantaha Pullingaha Lik Shabdaha. Right? This is the description of the Pratipadikam. We know Hakarantaha Pullingaha Lik Shabdaha. Lik is a Shabda or it's a Dhatu? Shabda or Dhatu? Lik
Dhatu.
Dhatu.
Lik is a Dhatu. Right? Lik is a Dhatu. What is the meaning of the word Lik?
To lick.
Yeah, it is lik, to lik, lik dhatu. Which gana is that? Lik dhatu. It is in second gana. Aswadane, adadi gana. Lik. Okay, aswadane. It's ubepadi. So, ubepadi. What is its pratama purusha ekavachanam? I'm just asking, adadi gana, pratama purusha ekavachanam.
Lady.
It is lady. Adadigana, it is Ubhayapadi, I said. So Parasmaipadi form is lady. We will see Adadigana, it is derived of this thing and tal. When we see, we will see. So lady is Pratama Purusha Ekavachana. It is lady. And Atmanipadi, it is lide. So lady, leadaha, lihanti, the rupam would be lihanti, bhagavachanam is lihanti. Lady, leadaha, lihanti. The t becomes dakara. Lekshi, leadaha, leada. Then lekhmi or lemi, lekhvaha, lekmaha. The rupam. So now the word lik, if it is a dhatu, then how can you decline? How can you decline the word lik? You cannot decline here dhatu. Lik, aswadane, adadi, gana, upepadi, dhatu. By bu, vadayaha, dhatavaha, lik, iti, shabdasya, dhatu sanya, asti. Dhatu hu chet. Dhatu hu chet, katam sup pratyaha bhavanti. Bhavati kim? No, it will come. No. Therefore, dhatu has to be converted into a pratipadika. How do you convert? We have a very safe, simple pratyaya, quip pratyaya. We have a pratyaya, quip pratyaya. Quip means the pratyaya having nothing. I mean, zero suffix, we say. The content of pratyaya is zero, nothing. Pakara is ith letter. Okay. What are the letters in this? Kakara. Let us write kakara, then pakara, then ikara, then pakara. These are the letters. Pakara is ith letter. By what sutra?
Alantyam.
Alantyam ith. Kakara is ith. By what sutra?
Lashakvatadite.
Lashakka taddite has got one anuvritti. Any kakara you will remove it?
Pratyaya.
That's important. Pratyayas. And, yes. And pratyaya also where the kakara should be there. That's important.
Adihi.
Very good. Adihi. So, if you see itta prakarnam, the word adihi and pratyaya is very important. Shaha pratyayasya. Sutra Visa Yit Prakaranam Shaha Pratyasya 1, 3, 6. And before that, Adihi Nitu Dagaha 1, 3, 5. The Adihi and Pratyasya comes as Anuvritti for the succeeding sutras. Chutu, Lashakutatite. Therefore, Adihi Nitu Dagaha, that Pratyaya is not there. You understand what I'm saying? I'm going to show the Sutra Pata. Pratyasya 1, 3, Shaha Pratyasya 1, 3, 6. 1 minute. That's important to be noted. Why it is not sometimes, it is not is because of this. If you see, 1, 3, 5 is Adihi Nitu Davaha. Where you see it too? Where do you see do and do? Where do you see ni? Yes, see that we will have. Yes, see.
Dhatu.
Dhatu is there. Any one dhatu where it is, do is there or to is there? Can you say?
Dukring karane.
Dukring karane.
Dukruj karane.
Dukring. And dupachesh also is there. Pach dhatu. Pach is dupachesh only. Do is itilator. Similarly, tuoshvi is there. Then ni is nishvida. Many are there. Many dhatus having nakara as ith letter. Is there any pratyaya the word here? No. Therefore, adihi ni to davaha for dhatu at all, it is applicable. The next sutra onwards, shaha pratyasya adihi comes anuvritti. That is why pratyasya adihi, not dhatu adihi. Can you remove the dhatu adihi? Suppose shadalu is there. What will happen? Suppose if you apply. Can you apply first of all? Shadalu is there. Shna is there. Shtu is there. Right? Can you apply this sutra? Shaha pratyasya. I will remove shakara as iterator. Can you apply? No. Because it is for the pratyaya. Dhatu is not a pratyaya. Right? That is why Shaddalavishna and all, Shakara stays. It has to stay. Otherwise, it will become Lopaha, becomes problem. We will not get the form. Therefore, it is Adihi Shaha, Pratyasya. Pratyasya Adihi Shakarasya, it Sangya Bhavati. Similarly, Pratyasya Chutu only. Adihi. Similarly, Pratyasya Ashakka Taditya. La, Lakara, Shakara, Kakara. Ataditya. Not in the case of Taditya Pratya. Taditya Pratya, this will not become Lopaha. That's why that atadite is there. In the case of other thing, it happens. Atadite also, pariyudasa pratisheda. So now here we have kakara. Kakara we have. Kakara is of kvip is. Kvip is a pratya. Therefore, pratyasya adihi kakarasya itsanya bhavati tasya lopaha iti sutrena. Lopaha sanya bhavati adarsham lopaha iti sutrena tasya adarshanam bhavati. Therefore kakara is itilata, right? Then what about vakara is now? How can you remove vakara? I said it's zero suffix, right? So vakara also has to go and ikara also has to go. How will you remove? If we say ikara is, if ikara, you can say, okay, it is upadesha anunasika.
Upadesha anunasika.
Therefore, it goes away. Suppose if you say upadesha anunasika, you can say, right? So, therefore, it is anunasika, it goes away. So now, does vakara goes away? Can you apply halantyam with?
Ekal pratyaya.
It's a ekal pratyaya, it's a sanya, but doesn't go away, right? Doesn't get sanya either later.
Special,
yes, what you said is correct. Ekal pratyaya, but you have to complete. It's not it over. Ekal pratyaya, pratyasya, lopaha bhavati. That is sutra.
Oh.
Ekal pratyaya is the pratyaya. Ekal pratyaya is called aprukta. Okay, aprukta is another sanya. I think we have seen this aprukta.
Yeah, we
right?
saw that aprukta ekal pratyaya.
We saw this. If you are not, we are going to see. I think the next sutra is going to come here. Or we are going to see that. We will define that. Don't worry, no problem. I think aprukta maybe sanya here, previous preceding sutra, it must be there. Just check it if it is there. Aprukta ekal pratyaya. If it is not there, anyway, I have to introduce that.
1241.
That's okay, but our number 81, 82, 83.
133.
Yeah, the number I think 133 is not that. Not yet done. This Alngi Abhyabdhirga Sutisya Pruktam Al is there. That Apruktam is there. Or 133. No, not there.
Okay,
no problem. Now it's good.
Last class we saw.
Oh, yes. Alngi Abhya introduced, right? Yes.
133 was the number.
Very good. Yes, you're right. So, therefore, the number is has to be changed now. This Alngiya Abhya Dirga Sutisi Apruktam Al, we saw last class. Sayyakanta Silopa also we saw, right? Both. The last class we saw both.
So, Sayyakanta Silopa, we have to see it. We didn't do that.
Okay. No problem. Sayyakanta Silopa, we will see. So, Apruktaya, this last class we saw this sutra, Alngiya Abhya Dirga Sutisi Apruktam Al. We discussed that, right?
Yes.
We discussed with the elaborately what is that. Not elaborately, whatever is required and other points also we saw. Okay, then. Sayyaganta Silopaha, I think we will see that later. Now, in this context only, this apruktam is there. What is apruktam we saw? So, aprukta ekal pratya. Let me make it as a aprukta ekal. What is the number you said? 1241. So, aprukta, this is 133. The sutra number is changed now. This is 133 and this is 134. Right? The sutra list we can have in this order. Okay, I will send you this. So, now, aprukta ekal pratyaya. So, now, if E goes away, then Vakara alone will be there. That's called Aprukta Ekal Pratyaya, one lettered Pratyaya. And by another sutra, aprukta, vehe apruktasya lopaha. That's a sutra. By that sutra, akara also goes away. Maybe that I think I can introduce that 135. Because in this subanta, you will see many times this kipratya being added, being used, because derived from the dhatu, kipratya is added. So we should know how this vakara goes away. So the next sutra is vehe, vera pruktasya. That is the next sutra. We'll see. Vehe apruktasya lopaha bhavati. So 1 to 41. Let me take it. Take that. 1 to 41. That 1 to 41 applicable for this quip pratyaya and quin pratyaya, etc. Aprakta ekal pratyaha. Let's see. Aprakta is a sanya. The sanya is only used in sutra. Alni abhyaha dirga suti si aprakta. Apraktam aliti. Fine. Aprukta eka, ekal pratyaya, one lettered pratyaya, get a sanya, aprukta. That's what sutra is. Aprukta ekal pratyaha, sanya sutra. What sanya? Aprukta sanya. Yaspin pratyaye, kevalam ekaha eva varnaha asti. Aprukta namna jnayate. That is known by the name aprukta. Vyakarana shastre, patitasu, sanyasu, anyatama asti, aprukta iti sanya. You can understand simple Sanskrit only. There is a sanya in the Vyakarana Shastra known by the name aprukta. Yaspin pratyaye ekaha eva varnaha vidyate tasya arane sutrena aprukta iti sanya bhavati. So only one lettered pratyaya, the one lettered pratyayas are called aprukta. Pratama ekavachanasya su pratyasya, we have seen this, it is su lopaha bhavati by upadeshe ajaranasika gita anantaram sakara iti kevalam ekal rupam avashishyate. One form alone is left. Therefore, it gets a sanya, aprukta. Lang lakarasya vigitasya pratama purusha vachanasya tipratyasya akarasya itsanya lope krute. That's also, I think we saw this last class, right? Lang lakara. Yeah, we did this. Aprukta ekal pratya. Right? We did this whole thing. Yes. Anyway. So in the lang lakara ti will become, the tipratya will become takara. The takara is aprukta ekal pratyaya, he says. Similarly in pipratya, the third example you can say, that is what we are interested in. Pipratya, where the kakara pakara ropam krutva, ucharanartam stapitasya vakarasya, vakara uttarasya ikarasya api ropam krutva, vakara alone avasishtaha. So tasya aprukta sanyaha bhavati. Now, this is aprukta ekal sanya. Okay, we are supposed to see the next sutra. Vehe apruktasya, that is what I wrote actually. Vehe apruktasya, that is sutra is 6167. Okay, that is what we are supposed to see now. 6167, what is that? It says, Vehe, Pratipadigam is, what is the Pratipadigam of Vehe? Vehe is Shashti Vibhakti, you know. You can see that.
Okay.
V is a pratipati. V.
Oh,
Arishabda. Arehe. Vehe. Vehe. Apruktasya. Apruktasya vehe. Shashti vibhakti vehe. So, the ve, that is V, which is aprukta, that becomes lopaha. That gets a sanya lopaha, and therefore adarsham lopaha. Bhavati. V iti asya aprukta vastayam. V is not aprukta. V, akara plus E is the. And E is ucharanartham. Therefore, aprukta avasthayam. Aprukta is ekal. Therefore, ekal avasthayam. Lopaha jayate, lopaha bhavati. V ityasya. Aprukta avasthayam, lopaha bhavati. Yadi kasmenchit pratyaye ekaha, kevalam ekaha varnaha drishyate, tarhi aprukta ekal pratyaha, anena sutrena tasya apruktas iti sanya bhavati. This we know, we have seen. One lettered pratyaya is called aprukta. अतः अनेन सूत्रेण एतत् उच्यते. दिस् इस् बीङ्ग् सेड् बै दिस् सूत्र वाट् यदि वि इत्यस्य इकारस्य लोपं कृत्वा वकारः इति के एकाल् प्रत्यय अवशिष्यते तर्हि वकारस्य लोपः भवति आफ्टर् डूयिङ्ग् दि अनुबन्ध लेटर् इ इकार बट् इस् ओन्लि फार् उच्चारणार्थं. वाट् इस् लेफ्ट् औट् इस् वकार दट् वकार विल् गो बि दट् इस् वाट् दिस् सूत्र सेस् वेहे अपृक्तस्य वेहे रेफरिङ्ग् टु दट् वि रेफरिङ्ग् टु the e for uchcharanantam therefore vakara vakara se lopaha bhavati that's what it says vityasya pin iti kashtana krit pratyah asti pin pratyaya pi pratyaya adisar krit pratyas dhatoho parah bhavati. There's a sutra sprasho nu the cake pin. All these things we are going to see later. We are going to decline these shabdas. Okay. इति अनेन स्पृश् इति अस्य पिन् प्रत्ययः भवति. स्पृश् इस् अ धातु विच्गण सिक्स्थगण त्वदादिगण धातु. सो इट् टेक्स् पिन् प्रत्यय. नौ वाट् विल् हेपन् टु पिन्? नकार इस् इत् लेटर्, ककार इस् लशकदधित इत् लेटर्. देयरफोर् वाट् इस् लेफ्ट् औट् नौ? वि अलोन् इस् लेफ्ट् औट् अण्ड् वि इस् इकार इस् उच्चारणार्थं तस्यापि लोपः जायते. देयरफोर् वाट् इस् लेफ्ट् फैनल् लेफ्ट् औट् वकारः एव अवशिष्यते. दिस् वकार अयं वकारः वि इति अस्मात् इकारं लोपं कृत्वा निर्मितः अस्ति. वकार इस् बिकास् आफ् द लोप आफ् द इकार. दर्फोर् वेहे मिन् वि से द वकार हेविङ्ग् इकार एस् द इत् लेटर् अनुनासिक इत् लेटर् दट् वकार वेन् इट् इस् अलोन् इस् दर् at the pratyaya, only one letter, that becomes lopaha. Vartamana sutrena, avashishtasya vakarasya, ekal pratyasya api lopaha bhavati. Right? Similarly, krip pratyaya, that is what we are seeing, krip pratyaya. Krip is zero suffix. So, queen is one, krip is another pratyaya. So, these are two important pratyas. We'll see, we can, in fact, krip pratyaya, you can add to any dhatu. Derive a pratipadikam. Any dhatu you can add. You can derive a pratipadikam. And pratipadikam denotes what? Denotes the karta. Because, okay, some additional information. Kartari krit. Krit pratyas are added in the sense of karta. Can you tell any krit pratyaya? We have seen.
Trich.
Very good. Another pratyaya?
Kaitavatu, Tuman.
No, no, no. I'm asking krit pratyaya denoting karta.
Nul, nul.
Yeah, very good. Nul pratyaya. Right? In fact, utsarga, in general, if it is not specific, krit pratyaya is kartari, denotes karta. So, krip pratyaya is also karta. So, when you say lik plus krip, you get lik. And lik, when it is declined, becomes lid, etc. You know, lid, lit. So, denoting the karta, the one who licks, denotes the karta. Okay. So, krip pratyaya, kartari, krit, and krip is krit pratyaya, therefore, denotes karta. Okay. So, therefore, here also, krip pratyaya also, Akara, Alantya, Mithu, then Kakara, Lashakutadite, then what is left out? V. And V also, that Ikara is for Uccharanartham, Akara alone is there. So, Aprukta Eka Lavastayam, Tasyapi Lopaha Bhavati, therefore, Vehe Apruktasya. Vehe, here, it is the Shashti Bhakti of V. And E, if it is Ananasika, it is Ananasika only. Then that Akara, which is Aprukta, that goes away. That is what the sutram says. Is it clear?
Yes, ji.
Yes, ji.
Similarly, the other examples are given. Nvi pratyaya and chvi pratyaya. These are some examples. Here also, you see nvi also. Nakara is. Nakara goes away by what sutra? In nvi.
Chutu.
Ah, pratyasya. Adihi chutu. Two. Remember that. So what is left out? V. V also ikara is uchcharanartham. Therefore, vakara alone is ekar pratyaya tasya lopam bhavati. Similarly, chvi. What is chvi? How the chakara goes away?
Chutu.
Chutu, right? The same. Chakara also goes away. Therefore, akara alone is there. Chi and all prataya, we will see. Chi prataya. Abhuta tadbhave. Chi prataya bhavati. Okay. Therefore, this is aprakta. Ekal pratya akarasya lopaha bhavati vehe apruktasya. Okay. So this sutra, the next sutra. Now coming back here. So therefore, vakara plus e, this also goes away. So what is the content now? Nothing. It is zero. That's why it's called zero suffix. Swamiji used to say, Bhaji Swamiji, that er is there. Eat plus er, eater denotes karta. Er is kartari, krit, like a krit pratyaya, like trish pratyaya, er pratyaya. It's in English. Eat, dhatu, plus er, eater denotes the karta. Then walk, er becomes walker. So if you add er, er, you get the, you get the word denoting the karta. Same thing here. But if you add the er to the word cook, what will happen? Cook plus er. Cook plus er will.
Huh?
It is cook only. What happened to er? Lopaha bhavati vehe apruktasya ikarasya lopaha bhavati and r also lopaha bhavati. Therefore zero suffix er goes away. Therefore cook only you get. Denoting karta, not cooker. If you say cooker, it becomes karanam, right? Cook plus er. Because if you say cooker, that is karanam. But er denotes er the pratyaya will denote karta only. In English also karta only. That's why cook. That er goes away. Zero. That's lopaha bhavati. The same thing here. Right? So therefore, by adding this kip pratyaya to the lik, you get Dhatoho paraha pratyaha bhavati krit pratyaha by krit tatitya samasasya, you get the word pratipadikam lik. Therefore, lik is a pratipadikam now. Lik is a pratipadikam. Therefore, can decline. Lik means what? Lady iti lik. The vipati, the one who licks, lady. Lady iti lik. It means liquor. That's the meaning. Lady iti lik. So the lik only we are going to decline. Declination is very simple. Already we have seen that we will see. We are going to do that Pratama Vibhakti and another all the Vibhaktis. Saranamastana we will do and Asaranamastana, then Basagya, then Savantri. Other forms you can easily know. Okay. So that we will do. We will see that in the next class. So we stop here. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada.
Please continue to read the sutra, whatever we have discussed. Try to recall.
Yes.
Thank you. Dhanyavada.
धन्यवाद.